Welcome back, Apostle Hope Emeka. God
Thank
bless
you very
you.
Much.
How are you?
I'm fine. God bless you, missionary Ekie Adams. I'm connecting from Cameroon.
Yes. Go forward in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. This is Tuesday, May 7th, 2019, and in Tacoma, Washington, United States of America. It is 4:11 in the afternoon. What time is it there? And is it May 7th or May 8th in where you are?
Yeah, this is 8th of May, 2019. This is
amazing.
12. This is 12:10 a.m.
Amazing. Isn't that amazing? I'm in May 7th and you're in May 8th. That is amazing. God is amazing.
Amen.
So time doesn't have, God is not limited by time. That's what I wanted to say. God is not limited by
time. Time is not a barrier to the agenda of God.
It's not even a consideration. It's amazing. So, Apostle Hope, tell me, we've been working together on this particular this manifestation today. We've been working towards this particular manifestation for how many years? When did we start?
Ooh, thank you so much. If I can remember vividly, I recall we've been on for the past 6 years now. I think we get connected on this channel in 2013. That is 6 years ago.
Isn't that amazing? God,
glory
that
to God.
My attention. Yes. And of course, we didn't have the technology 6 years ago. We didn't have the capabilities that we have today. And the reason I'm bringing that up is because so many times I said, is this me, or Lord, is this you? Do you want this? And it was just last week, he brought me all the way back to when we met and even before we met, and how he put the desire in my heart to connect Africa and America. Not that there wasn't anyone else doing it. That wasn't it. It was that he wanted to use me as a vessel to connect Africa and America. And I met you, and I was so absolutely stunned that you were in Nigeria. And that's where my father is from, my biological father from Nigeria. And finally, long at last, here we are on the TV channel that he told me to put together. I didn't know what I was doing, but here we are. Apostle Hope, you have the right name, Hope. Apostle Hope. You know, Abraham, his name was changed from Abram to Abraham before he ever had a child. How about that?
Yes. God actually have to change his name, because Abraham means the father to nations. And God has to give him many nations. So God has to give him the name that can suit his purpose for his life. That's why he has to change his name. Yeah.
I just want to say a shout out to Evangelist Gloria Durant. Beautiful, beautiful lady in the Lord. I love her ministry, her family, and her pastor is Nate Wilson. First lady is Venetia Wilson. I love them tremendously. They're wonderful, wow. Wonderful people. Yes, yes. Evangelist Durant and I were in the same class, and she was an encouragement to me. And Pastor and First Lady Wilson, beautiful encouragement to me. As a matter of fact, Pastor Wilson gave me a tripod lamp many, many years back. I really appreciated that investment he put in me. So I just wanted to, since this is a milestone in our ministry, your ministry, my ministry, our ministries, I definitely wanted to include that. And this is one video I'm not deleting. I don't, with all the imperfections, I am not deleting it. Honor and glory to the Most High God, our Heavenly Father, in the name of our Redeemer, the very living Son, born of a virgin. Hallelujah. Isn't Amen. That amazing? The Son of God, of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, our Heavenly Father. It's amazing. Go ahead, Apostle Hope. Go in the Holy Ghost.
Ooh, thank you, Jesus. Yeah, thank you, Evangelist Missionary Ekie Adams, for this connection. It is indeed the plan of God and His purpose for us. And we give Him all the glory. Shall we pray?
Amen.
Amen. Receive all the glory. Receive honor. Receive all the glory. Receive honor. Receive all the glory, Lord. Receive all the honor. Receive all the glory, receive honor. We are grateful, oh Lord. I am grateful, Lord. I am grateful, oh Lord. Oh yes. For all you have done for us. Hallelujah. I am grateful, oh Lord. Father, we thank you. We are grateful to you, oh God in heaven, because it is by your mercy that we are not consumed. We are grateful to you because you are our Father, you are our Lord, you are our Maker. We give you all the glory because you are the pillar that holds our life. We give you all the honor because you are the architect that owes our life. Lord, we thank you. You are omnipotent. We thank you. You are omniscience. We thank you because you are omnipresence. Thank you, Jehovah Yahweh. Thank you for a day like this. Thank you, Lord, for this prayer that is connecting the continent of Africa and the continent of America and the whole world together. Thank you because you are releasing your grace upon every soul that is connected to this prayer hour. Lord, I thank you because your word never fails. Thank you because you are the same yesterday, you are the same today, and you are the same forever. Jesus, we thank you for your grace at work in our lives. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you, O God, because before we begin to call upon you, you have heard us. Thank you, Lord, for every prayer that we are going to pray this minute that you have heard us. Jesus, I thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name we pray. Everlasting Father, I pray this minute because you said, I shall decree a thing and it shall be made established. And Lord, you said, whatever we shall ask in the name of your Son Jesus Christ, believing by faith, it is done unto us. Therefore, Lord, this minute, by the grace of God, I begin to pray, O God, because your word said the harvest is ripe, but there are fewer laborers in the field. And Lord, you said, behold, I come quickly, and my reward is in my hand. O Lord, we pray that the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ be spread abroad, be spread across. Any power from the pit of hell that is waging war against the propagation of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, every antichrist spirit, anti-Christian spirit that is fighting against the preaching of the word of God in all the continents of the earth, in Asia, in America, in Africa, in the Middle East, Lord, we decree that their plans and their activity be seized by the blood of Jesus Christ. For salvation is not in any other name, but in the name of Jesus Christ. Therefore, Lord, we decree by your power, by your spirit, by your anointing, we decree that the light of the gospel shine in all the earth. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we pray that souls will be saved, that souls will come to repentance, that the kingdom of heaven and the kingdom, oh God, be populated this time in the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, I want to pray for as many that are down, held bound by sickness or diseases, body pains, pains in the bones, pains in the eyes, pains in the waist. Lord, any form of afflictions that the enemy has placed upon them, under the sound of my voice, wherever they are, whether at the hospital, no matter the report of the doctor, su maralush lahan de lebradosala, ye kendeleu sukush le kente lagada bradashala, endalados makala shek ende bradasu untulagada. Lord, I do not care to know. You stuck me in your word and you said, upon Jesus Christ was the chastisement that made us whole. And Lord, you said, by your stripes, we are healed. Therefore, Lord, by the grace of God upon my life as your servant, I pray that anyone held bound by the spirit of sickness be healed right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I cause that spirit of sickness to disappear from their body, to disappear from their body, to disappear from their body. And you women that is held with arthritis, rheumatism, pains in the body, I command that pain to leave your body right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, whatever that pain is situated in your legs, no matter whatever the doctor has reported, no matter they have diagnosed in your bones, your arteries, malaria, typhoid, STD, HIV, I command that sickness to vanish right now. Paralysis, leprosy, Lord, by the name of Jesus, for how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth, who went about doing good and healing all manner of diseases. Receive your healing right now. Marush lahandelegeda. Receive your healing right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive your healing right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I say receive your healing right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive your healing in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for healing. Divine touch, divine healing upon every one of them. Salush legede pradosala in the maranda shahande legede losala. Lakush lagada yegede brada ende legada. Father, I remember in your word, Father, you said that upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance and holiness, and then the sons of Jacob shall possess their possession. Father Lord, you said we shall call upon you even in the days of trouble. You will answer us and you shall deliver us. Lord God Almighty, I pray. You said the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he's anointed my head with oil to proclaim freedom, liberty, deliverance upon anyone that is oppressed by the enemy. Lord, wherever any family, any individual, any incorporation, wherever there's an oppression of demon, for this purpose the Son of God is made manifest, that he might destroy the works of the enemy. Let there be deliverance right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I set loose, whoever, wherever the enemy has placed bond in their lives, I set you free. I set you free. Every oppression of witchcraft, occultism in your life right now, be free in the name of Jesus Christ. Every power that has caused you sleepless night, let them be banished out of your life, out of your destiny, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Jehovah Lord, the Most High God, at the mention of your name, every knee bows, every tongue confess that you are Lord. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but we wrestle against principalities, we wrestle against powers, we wrestle against demons of the world, wrestle against spiritual wickednesses in the high places, wrestle against spiritual wickednesses in the high places, wrestle against powers of darkness. And therefore, Lord, set your people free. Deliver your people. Deliver your people. Deliver your people. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I want to release grace of success, grace of favor right now, wherever you are connected to this video broadcast. In place of shame, I decree, I prophesy upon your life, God will give you favor in the name of Jesus Christ. For David said, he has brought me out of a miry clay, and he has set my feet upon the rock to stand, and he has caused me to sing a new song. The Lord will give you beauty for your ashes. in the name of Jesus Christ. Wherever they have placed stagnancy, garment of weeping, garment of shame upon your life, God is removing them right now. Your weeping is ending today. Joy is coming upon your life in the name of Jesus Christ. I prophesy into your life promotions right now, favor of God upon you right now, blessings of God upon your life right now, breakthrough financially upon you right now. Oh God, we break the chains and the spirit of disappointment out of your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you. Thank you because when I call you, you help me and you answer me. La kush la handele gede la dubrado shala handelea. In the la anche le endus le gede brado shala gada. Ma shala handele gede lo onso lo gado. Inge dele gede bragada sholo gado la gada. Ma anto sholo gado shala gede le endele gede le bro shala. In kanta la gada. Somebody, you are hearing the sound of my voice. You have been in rejection, you have been in frustration, and you have been asking God, why, when will you take away this predicament from my life? And hear me, the Lord said, is giving you double honor in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God said, is giving you double honor. Wherever you have been rejected, you shall be celebrated. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I hear God say double honor upon you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, a woman that has been in pains, you have been in shame, you have been crying to God for the fruit of the womb, lakush lahandelegeda. God, I visited Hannah, we visit you. The Lord, I visited Sarah, we visit you. The Lord, I visited all the women in the scriptures, they will visit you. They will visit you right now. Receive your miracle baby in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive your miracle child in the name of Jesus Christ. As I lay my hand upon you right now, I decree that heaven will answer you and give you your miracle baby in the name of Jesus. Lord, I decree let heavens be open. Let business opportunity be open to your people. Promotion be open to your people. Doors of favor be open to your people. Doors of deliverance be open to your people. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you. Lakado shalagada brada. Enshele entelegede malus lehendelegedelia. Makadosh lehendelegedel. I give you praise. I give you all the glory for all the things you have done. For the woman you have given the child. For that person, oh God, you have given double honor. Lord, for the very person, oh God, you have healed from the sick bed in the hospital. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' most holy name, we have prayed. Amen. 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 Somebody shout aloud, amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Our God is a good God. Indeed, our God is good. He never fails. God never fails. He never fails. That is one good thing, one assurance we have in him. He has been from the beginning, he is now, and he is forevermore. I want to assure you that if you have been part of this prayer, expect a miracle. There are testimonies of what God has been doing. Before we pray, he has heard us. And I want you to know that if you have joined that prayer, you will testify in the name of Jesus Christ. There is no doubt of what God is doing. There is no doubt. There is no doubt. There is no doubt. There is no doubt. I want to thank God for all he has been doing. Thank God for missionary Ekie Adams. Thank God for this connection. And I just want to share something briefly to the world. What God has given to me to share to the world. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. You see, the church is waxing cold. The church has forgotten the purpose the church seems to have forgotten the gospel that Christ has commanded us to preach. And a lot of things have been happening in the body of Christ and in the entire world. And I want us to understand that we are in the last days. And in these last days, God has asked me to tell the world that his coming is at hand. The Lord revealed to me, and he said to me, "Son, sound the trumpet and let them know that I come very soon. I come very soon. Whatever you are doing, wherever you are, I want you to understand that the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ is at hand." And somebody will say, "Pastor, Apostle, how do you know? How do you know? The signs are everywhere." If you go to your news, if you tune in to your telecast and broadcast, you will hear news of all the signs in the book of Matthew chapter 24 that Jesus said, "By this you will know that my coming is at hand." There are signs of war. There are signs of earthquake. You know, all kinds of crises, family crises, church, kingdom rising against kingdom, nation rising against nation. But I want you to know that you should prepare for the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's a message that God has given to us. He's coming very soon, and he is coming to rapture the church. In Ephesians chapter 5, verse 27, and also in John chapter 14, verse 1, he made us to understand that he is going to prepare a place for us. And he is coming back to take us to be with him. Amen. Is that not wonderful? Is that not wonderful? Isn't that amazing? He is coming again. Jesus is coming again. So do not live your life as if you are ending here on earth. We have a life eternal. But it is not everybody that will be qualified to live with him or to rapture with him. Amen. Praise the Lord. It is not everyone. He said, "I am coming to present to myself a glorious church. A glorious church. A church without spot. A church without wrinkle. A sanctified church. A unholy church." You see, a church that is pure. This is the kind of church he is coming for. And that is why the Bible said he died. He gave himself as a sacrifice to our redemption so that we might believe in him. And when we believe in him and we give our life to him and we became born again and we now belong to the family and the citizens of God, then we are qualified to rapture with him. We are qualified to reign with him. We are qualified to live with him in eternity. Friends, there is heaven and there is hell. The worst thing that can happen to a man is to gain the whole world and you lose your soul. Jesus is coming back very soon. Jesus is coming to take us. Therefore, I would like us, if you know you are still living in sin, if you know you are still living, you are still living like a sinner, this is the time for you to repent from your sin. This is the time for you to accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. This is the time for you to turn a new leaf and begin to follow Christ. This is a time for you to turn a new leaf because there is eternity And when a man dies, it is judgment. The life you live on earth determine where you will be after death. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just want to share with us briefly, Jesus Christ is coming very soon. He said, "Behold, I come quickly." In Revelation chapter 21, I think 22 verse 20, he said, "Behold," let us see Revelation 22 verse 20. Amen. Revelation 22 Amen. Verse 20. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
All right. Amen. It said, "Behold, I come quickly, and my reward." I can quickly get a scripture where it is. But as that scripture begin to come to my spirit, and my reward is in my hand. Jesus is coming very soon. Friends, I would like you to know that Christ Jesus will come very soon. And if you are ready, if you're not ready, it will be too late at that moment, because there's no repentance after rapture. There is no repentance in the grave. There's no repentance after death. The only repentance you can repent is now. Now is the acceptable time. Now is the day of salvation. Yes. Now Revelation is the day of acceptance.
Yes, now is the time.
Now is the time of acceptance.
Behold, I come quickly.
Yes. Yeah, behold, yes. I come quickly. Revelation 22.
And Lord with me to give every man according as his work.
Yes, 22 verse 12.
Uh-huh, 12 to 14. Or 12 to 20. You can read that right.
Yeah.
Revelation 22.
Verse 12. Yeah. "Behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man according to his work shall be." Amen. That is the scripture God is giving to me. He's coming quickly. A lot of us have forgotten that Christ is coming again. A lot of preachers don't want to tell us about his coming. They don't want to remind us about his coming. But God is not happy. God, because his word has come forth. And I want you to know that Jesus is coming again. He said, "Behold," and he's coming to reward us according to how we have lived here on earth. Friends, Christ is coming again. Prepare your way. Live a good life as a Christian. Let the life that you're living be the life that, you know, is worthy. It is the life that God will look at you and say, "Well done, my son. Well done, my servant." The Bible said, on the last day, he will say to many, "Get ye behind me, because ye are the workers of iniquities." Oh, Jesus. I don't want to be in that position. I don't want to find myself in that situation. I say, God, help us. Help me, O Lord. So that after I have run the race on the last day, I will not be a castaway. Friend, I want to pray with you. I want to pray with you. I want to pray with you. I want you to understand that the word of God has gone forth, and he that has ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying. So wherever you are falling short, you are backsliding, or you are still living in sin, in fornication, you are still living in adultery, you are still living in drunkenness, backbiting, jealousy, envy, you are still living in idolatry, I want you to understand that this is the time for you to repent and turn back to Jesus. Because if you die now, you will not make heaven. So Jesus is calling you. He's knocking at the door of your heart. Open your heart to him. Open your heart to him so that he will come in and dwell in your heart. Let me pray with you. If you want to come, he said, come unto me, all you that labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Jesus will give you rest today. And your name will be written in the book of life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you for your word. As many that are hearing my voice, and I want to turn a new leaf, and I want to give their life to you, Jesus, I pray that you accept them, wash their sins, oh God. Remove their name from the book of death and put their name in the book of life. Lord, I pray, oh God, that you have mercy upon their life. And you come into their life, oh God, sanctify, purify, wash them by the blood, and make them one of the citizens of the kingdom of heaven. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for these great ones that are coming to repentance, that are coming into you. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Amen. Shout a better hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo! Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank God for you. Thank God for you, your ministry. Thank God for all of God's vessels. It's wonderful. This is a beautiful, beautiful manifestation today. My heart is really very, I'm very, very glad. Very, very glad. I did put the scripture down there for not everyone that says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter into the kingdom of heaven. We do know that, but I'm going to paste that in the comments so that it's there for whosoever will be reviewing this later. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Apostle. And Apostle, hope you have a YouTube page, and I saw another page regarding your music ministry. You want to share a little bit about that?
All right. God has been so wonderful. Yeah, my YouTube page, and it's Chukwuneme Emeka. You see, and my ministry and music, God has called us, you know, to preach the gospel in words and in music. And that is why he has given me that inspiration to do the songs. I have a couple of songs, but I'll be yet to be released. And I would like you to go to that YouTube channel and listen to the music. It is prayer. God will give you your portion in Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you. Yes. Thank you so much. Beautiful. Thank you so much.
If they go to your Facebook page, that information is on your Facebook page as well.
Okay, okay. That's good. It's okay. You can go to my Facebook page and join in and watch the video. Remember, the prayer we prayed is for somebody. And the anointing of God will locate you through this video. You will testify. You will testify.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Well, this broadcast was a little, well, it was totally impromptu. We didn't plan it. But we know that God already knows every day, every hour, every minute, every second, ahead of time. So I am, again, very excited. I thank God for you. God bless you. You have a prayer line as well. Tell us a little bit about your prayer line, your prayer group.
Okay, my prayer group is the Global Prayer Apostolic Network. We are praying for, you know, praying for all nations of the earth, because the devil is on rampage. The devil is at work. The devil is busy, you know, polluting the heart of people, especially Christians. So that is why God has given me the burden to pray for the body of Christ, to pray for all the nations of the earth, you know. And we have been on. You can connect to us through WhatsApp. All right. Connect up through WhatsApp group, Global Apostolic Prayer Network. We pray for all the nations. In every session, we begin to mention all the nations of the earth so that the gospel of the Lord shall be spread abroad. Power that is waging the gospel, the Lord will dethrone them. All the territorial demons, all the princes of the earth that does not want the gospel, the light of the gospel to shine in nations. God has taken me to some various countries in Africa. I saw thick darkness fighting against the gospel. I saw dark kingdom of darkness fighting against the gospel. But we have not, we should not be sitting down. That we said the kingdom of heaven and of God suffered violence, and the violence taketh it by force. It is by violence in prayer we can take charge. Christian can take charge. So that is why God has given me the burden to create that group. And in that group, we pray for all the nations of the earth. And as you join the Lord, we give you your own testimony in the name of Jesus Christ.
Beautiful. Wonderful. Well, this is not. I am trying to coordinate while we're online, but I'm learning as I go, and I hope that this broadcast will encourage other ministries, large, small, in between, to do the same thing. There's so many. I say billions of souls that need to be ministered to, and we need more than 100 or 1,000 ministries to broadcast. We need many, many more, because there's so many souls. But I thank you, Apostle Hope Emeka, for answering the call and going forth to bring in the harvest. Amen. Harvesting the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. Amen. Thank God for you. And let's end this broadcast. I know we're excited. We could go on for hours. And there'll be another day we will go on for hours. We may just have a marathon go on all day long.
Amen.
Thank God for the Lord continue to bless you and yours in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I'm going to go to your Facebook page and share your portion of the video on this Facebook page. So I thank God for you. Continue to be encouraged. And until the Lord allows us to meet again, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Bye-bye now.
Amen. All right. Thank you.
Thanks so long.
Amen.